नित्यानंदेश्वर समारंभाम् नित्यानंदेश्वरी मध्यमाम् अस्मदाचार्य पर्यन्ताम् वंदे गुरु परंपराम्। I welcome all of you with my love and respects. I welcome all the devotees, disciples, samajis, satsangis, everyone sitting with us all over the world through Nityananda TV, Facebook Live, YouTube Live, and two-way video conferencing. Today, sixth day of Navaratri, as Navaratri celebrations, Adi Shakti is gracing in the Sarvalankara, served by Lakshmi and Saraswati, and the other side, Venkateshwara is continued to grace in the form of Mohini on the Swarna Hamsavahana, golden swan vehicle, as part of the Venkateshwara Brahmotsavam, day 5th. So, let's receive their blessings and enter into satsang.
Om Sarva Mangala Mangalye Shive Sarvartha Sadike Sharanye Trambake Gauri Narayani Namostute Srishti Sthiti Vinashanam Shakti Bhute Sanatani गुणाश्रये गुणमये नारायणि नमोस्तुते शरणागत दीनार्थ परित्राण परायणे सर्वस्यार्थि हरे देवी नारायणि नमोस्तुते। ओम निरंजनाय विद्महे निराभासाय धीमहि तन्नो श्रीनिवास प्रचोदयात्। कर्पूरगौरं करुणावतारं संसारसारं भुजगेन्द्रहारं सदा वसन्तं हृदयारविन्दे भवं भवानी सहितं नमामि भवं भवानी सहितं नमामि भवं भवानी सहितं नमामि।
Let's enter into today's satsang. Listen. Today the important truth I wanted to share with all of you, especially preparing all of you for Sadashivoham 2016, the science of bliss, understand? Just yesterday I was sharing with few of my Adinavasis. I have made few people as Chief Integrity Officer, CIO. I was revealing some of the important truths about the integrity. Listen, actually, if somebody has eyes, do you need to tell them, hey, 3 feet pit is there, on the right side of the road, 4 feet stone is sitting in the left side of the road, and outside the gate fire is burning on the street, somebody has put the tire and they are burning, so take left turn, then after some time one big cobra is lying down, so go right side? No. If somebody has eyes, they will manage all this. You don't need to tell everything. Understand? Integrity also is a simple vision of reality. Why it looks so complicated, you know? Your brain gets covered with a thin, subtle layer of pitta. which puts you in certain delusion constantly makes you believe your assumptions, assumed fears as a part of your reality. Listen. Listen to this word carefully. If you use the virtual reality equipment, you can understand. First, when you put it, it looks like externally something has been put. After half an hour or 1 hour, you forget something is on you and you just become one with it. Same way, when your brain is covered by a thin, very subtle layer of pitta, certain amount of sadness and withdrawal, frustration, powerlessness, lower frequency of existence becomes your functioning style. Only there, because you feel so powerless, you think, let me do anything and manage the situation. It is like your house is on fire, your dad is in the office, he comes to know and he screams at you through the phone, where is the house key? First take it. And you receive that instruction. You run and search all around and just get the house key and come back and stand outside and let the house burn. And then you come and tell me, no, you told me where is the house key and I am having it. The most cunning way of breaking any law is follow the letter, forget the spirit. Most cunning way of breaking any law. Follow the letter, forget the spirit. You will break it very technically and intelligently without getting caught. I tell you, this subtle layer of pitta, first thing it does is puts you in the space where you believe all your imagined fears are part of your reality. If you imagine certain fear that you are going to get certain disease, you are going to get into certain situation, you already will strongly believe it is part of you. It's not that going to come, may come. In your cognition, you will just know it is. Actually, as part of the Shashtanga Yoga, Sadashiva gives one important instruction in Agama. Please understand. The system we follow is Shashtanga, not Ashtanga. Shashtanga Yoga by Sadashiva. He gives an instruction. Tremendous sattvic bliss, ananda, comes from non-violent activities. Bliss comes from non-violent activities. Understand? That is what he calls sattvic ananda. He says that is an antidote for that layer of pitta to be cleansed. Please understand, today what I am talking is the right reason and context why you should be always blissful. Why you should be with and in Nityananda. That is why I just explode when I see my sons and daughters jump. when my kids jump, I know, I tell you, happy person will always be highly integrated, highly efficient, and never cunning. Never cunning. When I see my kids are jumping, my boys and girls, I know my DNA is growing. Actually, that is the way Arunagiri Yogeshwara brought me up. That is the way my gurus have brought me up. It was such a joy to be with them and to hang around them. Fortunately, I had the age in my advantage. Only I used to be bullying them. They never bullied me. It is such joy to see my kids jump. Actually, I get up and come, don't miss satsang, just to see my kids only. It's for my sons and daughters I come and sit every day here. I know for 100% sure, this is Sattvika Ananda. See, the kids are so happy. My sons and my daughters, my boys and girls jump. It is completely Sattvika Ananda. You are not harming anybody. You are not violating anybody. Sattvika Ananda has a capacity of penetrating and breaking that pitta layer. Sadashiva gives Sattvika Ananda. Please understand, let me define that word. Sattvika Ananda means any activity which comes by non-violence, the joy which comes by the activity of non-violence. That has a capacity. It can be from puja, it can be from kirtan, it can be from unclutching. Any joy, bliss, oozes in your system with a non-violent activity. The moment they see me, they are so happy. When I see them, I am so happy. That's all. A joyful person will be always highly efficient and highly integrated. Well, you know, when that pitta layer is broken, cleaned, the person will not believe the imagined suffering and pain is part of their reality, so they will not adopt non-integrity as a strategy for their thinking. Understand? Your cognition about you is very important. Because only based on what you think about you, you adopt the strategies for your life. There are some people, do anything, do not bother about integrity or value or the larger visions of life. If you are going to get half a kg meat now, if you are going to get 1 pound flesh now, kill. Destroy. This can be done only by a person whose brain is covered with the pitta layer, who does not have the high frequency as their existence. Understand? If at all we can add Sattvika Anandas to people's life, the whole world will become integrated. Because integrity is a, you see, when your brain does not have that coating of pitta, you will not believe suffering is your innate tendency. And you will simply know the simple strategy for life is integrity. It is like a you, how you breathe. How you breathe. It will just be integrity be your life. Listen. Listen very carefully. Any sattvic ananda, bliss which comes by non-violent actions, melts down, tears down that pitta layer, makes you see life with larger vision. Happy people will be the most efficient people, most integrated people. Advait came in, my Gurukul principal came and asked me about few kids who need to be given Krama Brahmacharya. The moment I heard their name and the moment I know how they jump here in the Kirtan, I know they are Brahmacharis. They can be given. They are complete. Only a complete person's body can be so alive. When your body is so alive and joyful and ecstatic, you are not hurting anybody and being joyful. You are not doing anything wrong and being joyful. You are joyful because Swamiji is here. They don't need much to be joyful. Just few of my teeth and one thumbs up, that's all. And their ecstasy shoots up, skyrockets. Sangadam seyyavarum samugathayellam sangaram seid sandadam enmagangal sandoshamayirupeergalaga. You are not being non-violent to anybody and being blissful. So if somebody stops, you have a right to defend yourself. You have a right to defend your joy and bliss. I tell you guys, how in the mother's womb, the fluid which is there is the space where the body of the child develops. Same way, this joy which I feel engulf you guys all around. If one teeth is seen, 32 teeth are seen that side. This joy is the liquid in which I grow you guys. You guys have the right for all the sattvic anandas. Understand? All sattvic bliss is your right, is your birthright. And you guys are Shaivites. Shaivite means joyful guys. We are Shaivites. We are joyful people. I tell you, joy destroys cunningness. Joy destroys this crooked thinking. Joy destroys lack of integrity. Joy gives you larger vision. Sadashiva himself, I tell you guys, when he lands in you, he will create an intense joy in your system. That is the way he will land. He is Lord of Ananda. I wanted to explain from the angle of the spiritual alchemy process about the reason for the sattvika ananda. Understand? Do not allow your physiology or psychology to enjoy any joy which comes by torturing anybody. Don't allow. Then you lose your shaivatva. No. You lose your shivatvamasi. No. Don't allow. Never allow any joy which comes by suffering of the other person, torture of the other person. No. Then your brain loses its capacity to hold Sadashiva in you. And always encourage, grow the sattvika anandas. Don't be shy to grow the sattvika ananda. Do not be shy to grow the bliss of sattvika, means non-violent joys should be grown so much into the system. I tell you, more and more dosage of non-violent bliss develops larger and larger vision of life. Sattvika ananda person gets, I can't even describe the benefits, because the benefits happening in the physical level, in the muscle memory level, physiological level, psychological level, when the pitta in your brain, that layer of pitta reduces, only then your system develops a power called eating its own dead cells and cleaning up, which is the energy of Rudra. Understand, listen. Just now, few days before, one fellow got Nobel Prize for physics. His research project, I studied his research project. Why he got? It is all about the science of how the body is eating its old dead cells and how it can be supported and encouraged. Please listen. For what he got the Nobel Prize now, at least 60,000 years before, elaborately Sadashiva describes. I can give you precise word. Now I think in English they use the word autophagy or something. I can give you the precise word in Sanskrit, in Agama, and the precise principle. Joy in the brain, first thing it does. Maybe some of my Adinavasis will be wondering, 24 hours last 6-7 days I was with him. When he read this, don't ask those questions. And precisely, the sattvika ananda, what it does, listen, it will clean up the pitta layer in the brain, means the layer which makes you powerless, tired, and withdraw from the life for no reason. So actually, when the pitta layer attacks you, suddenly you will feel like frustrated and don't want to get involved with anything. If you come face to face with your mother-in-law or boss, or the people whom you don't want to see, what happens to you at that moment? Imagine that's the same thing, the pitta layer spreading. Listen, this sattvika ananda first thing cleans up that subtle layer of pitta, that is one. Second, it awakens the Rudra energy in you, which makes your system eat all the dead cells and dead parts of you and clean up. Just clean up. And this cleaning up is very important to keep you young, to keep you energetic, to keep you healthy, to keep you blissful. As long as this Rudra energy is alive in you, you will not die, you will be immortal. Sattvika ananda awakens that Rudra energy in you intensely, I tell you. At any cost, whatever you have to give up to live with the happy people, sattvically happy people, just go and be with them. That is satsanga. And plan sincerely to make that same kind of a sattvika ananda in your home and workplace. Where you are working, in your home, both places. A very simple thing. A non-violent joy will actually make your workplace productive. It will become productive. I am telling you, even in my sangha, only the people who are joyful are productive. Everyone else is a load. It's a load only. I have many pillars, supporting pillars and hanging pillars. No, joyful people are all supporting pillars. They will be highly efficient, highly integrated, have a passion for sattvic ananda, have romance with sattvic ananda. The non-violent bliss, peaceful bliss, where you don't hurt anybody, but it is joy for you. Grow more and more of sattvic ananda in your system. Activities which makes the sattvic ananda in your system, you will become efficient, you will become integrated, you will be just glowing, you will be completely healthy. The Rudra energy in you will be so alive. You will be young forever. It's an amazing beauty technique. Now women don't need any other convincing reason or the context to practice. Done. Only for men I have to give the remaining reasons. The moment I know the way the body of the kids move, see, when they jump, dance, the way the body moves itself, I know, yes, this kid has come to integrity. He has lost all the cunningness. He is no more cunning. Or the joy, when the joy can become a lubrication for all the body joints and move, you can't retain cunningness anymore in your system. You just have to be... See, joy always makes you integrated. For example, if there is high water level in Ganga, you don't have to worry about the stones in the bed, river bed. You can just go in the boat or ship or whatever. If the water level is low, you need to worry about the stones and everything. The river bed, boat cannot travel comfortably. Same way, in high joy only integrity boat can travel in your life. Immediately, the moment he said, I just saw, who are those kids? Yes. And I know because I am seeing them here morning and night. And I know what is the space they will go and sleep if they jump and breathe my breathing space for such long time. I tell you, joy, sattvika ananda makes you a Shaivite. That makes you live Shuddhadvaitam. That makes you live Sadashivoham. Sattvika ananda is one of the most important alchemy you need to do in your system as a preparation for Sadashivoham 2016. Actually, if you are a participant in the kirtan and jump, I tell you, so much of sattvika ananda, biomemory will get into your system, it will help you in every process so powerfully. See, especially when you jump and all that, the bliss is inhaled by every pore of your body. Every pore of your body, the bliss is inhaled. It becomes part of your muscle memory and biomemory. Of course, doing puja is surely sattvic ananda. But you don't use the whole body to do puja. But with these kirtans, it's like a whole body is used. The way your body flows with that, I can tell you, the level of integrity you have and the efficiency are the vision about life. All the sad people are cunning fellows. Never believe sad people. Never believe sad people. Never believe their words. Never have them as your business partner or life partner. They can suck your life and destroy your life. If you can make them sattvically blissful, do it. If not, at least save yourself. Get rid of them. I'm telling you. Because sad people can talk about integrity but never be integrated. They will only be cunningly strategizing. Like that only, if the sad fellow, even if he is integrated, he is waiting to ditch you in some bigger deal. He is having his knife behind the back. Never ever believe sad people and get into any venture. That is like a getting onto the mud horse and entering into Ganga. Never. Whether life partner or business partner, joyful people will never cheat you. Even if they shout at you, it will be straightforward. There will not be second layer. There will not be third layer. Never believe sad people, even if they show very humble, polite, very good, decent, civilized manner of behavior. A raw, joyful person is 1,000 times trustworthy than the sad, civilized, decent, presentable. No. Sad fellows are dangerous fellows because in their very pitta layer on the brain, they believe all the fears are part of their life. When somebody is frightened, he is the most dangerous fellow. He will be all the time in the mood of attacking. I tell you, keep sattvic bliss as your lifestyle and defend it. Defend it, and you have a right to defend it. Don't allow the stupid society to interfere in your sattvic bliss. You are not violating into anybody's space and being joyful. You are joyful just because I am here and my joy, sharing it. And nobody has a right to interfere and intimidate our joy. If they intimidate, they give us the right to retaliate. I tell you, make sattvic joy as your lifestyle. And stand for it strongly. And I tell you, spread Sattvic joy in the world. Conduct more and more kirtans in your places. Conduct more and more of pujas, meditations, yoga, unclutching sessions. Spread more and more of Sattvic joy. You will be doing such good to the world. Sadashiva will be happy with you. Just like how I am happy when I see my kids jumping. The highest level my eyes open up is only when I see my boys jump. When I see my boys jump only, all my 1,000 eyes open up and I enjoy it. And I know my Yuvarajas are getting ready. I tell you, it is actually Sattvic Ananda gives the strength in biomemory. Understand? The core stuff of biomemory gets strengthened by Sattvic Ananda. Do not allow the violence-based joy, even for 5 minutes, it is a poison. You are chewing poison, don't. It's a cyanide kuppi. The cyanide pill, don't. Always. I think all of you understand the difference between violent joy and non-violent joy. Violent joy means abusing, attacking, or torturing, or somebody suffering becomes source of your joy is violent joy. Never allow. That smug you carry when somebody is tortured, never allow. When you see somebody smile, the way you jump is Sattvic joy. Especially when you see me smiling and jump, it is Shaivite joy. Not it's beyond Sattvic joy. It is just joy of Sadashiva being enjoyed by all of you guys. Build Sattvic joy that will empower you to manifest all the powers. See, for example, first I made my kids to see the past, present, future on the leaf. Then I moved to mirror. Now I am moving to granite. Already granite is ready. Why, you know, the kind of the intense energy leaf can hold only certain frequency and mirror can hold maybe 10 times more. But granite can hold 1,000 times more. It can retain its original shape and continue to mirror, show what needs to be shown. Just like how granite can hold the higher frequency and do its job, Sattvic bliss infused in your biomemory can hold my higher energy in you and radiate as powers. A sattvically joyful kid will be the perfect, complete sannyasi. He will be such perfect sannyasi. I can just go on giving any amount of powers to him, powers to her. Her biomemory will literally hold me itself. I can even just go and sit inside them and it will hold. Because the Sattvic joy has a capacity to burn away, digest your old patterns, your old muscles, your old muscle memories and your dead cells. Whenever somebody becomes happy after they declare completion, I will believe their completion. Yes, this fellow will come out of, because that sattvic joy will eat away the old muscle memory and old muscles and the old all unnecessary things. The Rudra energy is now awake in them. They will become complete. They will live with completion in the future. But when the completion is done, I am completing and I am. I am completing. In future, I know. Fraud fellows. No, joy will eat all the old dead cells and dead muscle memories. Sattvika Ananda is an important alchemy need to be done in you for you to manifest Sadashivoham, because it works on your physical, physiological, psychological and muscle memory, biomemory, your whole consciousness. Sattvically joyful person, you can always hand over your whole house key to them. They will neither steal your wealth nor steal your wife. Now I am telling you. Now some may not steal your wealth, but they will steal your wife. What will you do? A sattvically blissful person will never steal any of yours. Like how Bharata and Shatrughna kept Lakshmana's wife. Bharata is the embodiment of dedication. I really want to have a temple for Bharata done here. From my point of view, Bharata is higher dedication and sacrifice than Lakshmana. Hey, being with Rama, even if you give your whole life, it is nothing. Just to be with Rama, you can do anything. But being away from Rama, just to keep up the Rama's words, is not a small joke. How he protected and cared Lakshmana's wife. A highly sattvically blissful person only can hold his integrity . Bharata has collapsed for what happened, what has been done to Rama, but he did not break his integrity because of the highly sattvic bliss biomemory built in his system. Anybody who is sattvically blissful, I can stand for their integrity. Integrity will be their lifestyle. I wanted to define the integrity. Integrity means being aligned and straight to the words you utter and the way you hold yourself for yourself and others. It is not just fulfilling the word and thought, you give it to yourself and to others. Sometimes without giving a word, through your body language, you give certain commitment to you and to others. Experiencing the state of Purnatva, even with the said unsaid declarations to yourself and others, is integrity. That is completion with yourself and with life. Why you don't become integrated? Because you see a small vision of life and you believe the wrong belief that tiger is chasing you, even though you are comfortably lying on your bed. But with the dream of belief of tiger is chasing you, jump from the bed and break your leg. Actually, breaking the leg is not because of the tiger, it is because of your wrong belief. Don't blame the tiger. You believe tiger is chasing you and you kick your leg even though you are in a comfortable bed and roll out and fall and break your leg. And then you say, because tiger was chasing me, I broke my leg. Because you believe tiger was chasing you, not tiger was chasing you. All your lack of integrity is because of your wrong belief about life. And sattvic joy gives such large vision. About life. I'll be so happy if my kids are 24 hours jumping and enjoying. That's all I want. You guys are Nityananda's sons and daughters. You guys don't need to do anything. Be in Nityananda. That's all. I will work for you guys. I will make food, clothes, shelter, whatever needed. I am capable father to get everything in the outer world and all the inner world things already I brought it. I don't even need to earn. Only outer world things at least I need to earn. It needs to come to our bank account. Inner world things are already, I am the reserve bank when it is inner world. Develop the sattvic ananda as much as possible. Involve yourself in the activities of the sattvic ananda as much as possible. Enjoy, celebrate, grow. Sattvic ananda, you will have so much of integrity, so much of straightforwardness, so much of efficiency, so much of honesty, so much of authenticity, so much of responsibility, so much of enriching, so much of completion, so much of listening, so much of causing. All the best qualities Sadashiva expects you to radiate. All the powers Sadashiva wants you to manifest. You will do everything. Just develop sattvika ananda in you. All activities for sattvika ananda is directly worshipping Sadashiva. Manifesting himself in you. Because your brain becomes the antenna to receive the wavelength of Sadashiva. It's like how you turn your dish to receive certain frequencies to certain direction. Sattvic ananda is the way you turn your brain to receive Sadashiva. Some of you may have question, I don't have what to do. So sattvic ananda will build one for you. Even if you don't have one. If you already have one, it will tune it for Sadashiva. If you don't have one, it will build for you to tune it to Sadashiva. Whoever did not laugh for this joke, understand you don't have a brain. You missed because you don't have one. Whole Sangha should put the energy everywhere to encourage more and more sattvic ananda activities. Everywhere, Sangha should go on be encouraging, be active about the activities to awaken sattvic ananda in people. Yoga, puja, meditation, kirtan, all this. more and more should be encouraged. I tell you, sattvic ananda is the only currency you can earn which will be useful for you when you are going to be out of this matrix. All other currency may be useful for the fellows who invented it, not for you. Sattvic ananda is the only currency which will be useful for you when you are going to be out of the matrix. And even make, you see, under the matrix there is one currency, outside the matrix there is one currency. So outside the matrix currency is sattvic ananda. Developing that, earn even the inside matrix currency. That is what is fulfillment in your career, fulfillment in your profession. Make money, somehow develop the system in such way. You go on developing outside matrix currency and inside matrix currency by doing the same action. It's possible. It's possible. Then your life is in tune with Sadashiva. Your life is in tune with Sadashiva. You can generate the currency inside the matrix by doing the activities which develops you the currency of the outside matrix, both. Currency of outside matrix is sattvikananda. Currency of the inside matrix, you know, gold or money of your country or whatever, whatever. Both can be developed by doing the same activity. It is possible. Start thinking in that line and work in that line. Your life will be in tune with sattvic ananda and sadashivoham. You may just need to apply your will, persistence, and look in. You will see so many doors will open up. Today we have a biomemory, muscle memory initiation session for inner awakening participants. Actually, if you guys have a personalized question, how to make the out of matrix currency and inside matrix currency both in your life, ask me the questions. I'll support and suggest and guide you guys today. How you can tune your life, doing the same activity, you develop both currencies. So your life is not wasted on stupid inside matrix currency. You can have this and that both. And maybe for Nityananda Yogam participants also can join the session and I can guide you guys. No, this can help you guys a lot to iron out your life. Surely, if we apply a little bit of will, persistence, it is simply possible. We will make it possible. If you earn both currency by same activity, that is called dharma. Even by earning the currency, you are doing only good. All of you can have Vakyartha Sadas today. On this subject, this is the Facebook status for all of you. Sattvic ananda, non-violent bliss, makes you manifest sadashivoham. Non-violent bliss makes you manifest sadashivoham. Sattvic ananda makes you manifest sadashivoham. So this is subject for Vakyartha Sadas for all of you. And this is the subject, Facebook status for all of you. So today, I will conduct specifically a session for all the IA participants and the Nityananda Yogam students, participants, Guru Purnima batch, Navaratri batch both. And IA volunteers. And IA volunteers too. You guys can ask me questions. I'll try to guide you in a personalized way, in your specific, the place where you are stuck. from that place, that space, how this can be developed and how you can manifest it. So with this, I bless you all. Let's all radiate with integrity, authenticity, responsibility, enriching, causing, living Shuddhatvaita Saivam, the eternal bliss, Nityananda. Thank you. Be blissful.